Hello, today I'm here with a new video, and today it is a first impression again, and with a ColourPop Monochromatic palette again. And today I'm doing Orange Chocolade. And yeah, as you know, I love orange. And this palette looks like... Okay. So, the front looks like exactly like the packaging, and it's so... reflective. And one thing that is bothering me is it fell off a little bit of color from the E. But yeah, the palette is a 9-pan monochromatic palette. I don't feel that this is like super orange, but I think I will like it, I hope. This is a pressed glitter that wasn't in the Blue Moon. Was no pressed glitter, and this is not intended for the eye area, and I think that is like the most silly thing ever. I am going to do my first impression with this, and I think I know what I want to do. I haven't decided fully, but I think I know. I haven't swatched this. Maybe I should have done that, but at the same time, no. So I think I just zoom in and we get started with this first impression, and it's a little fly here. So, okay, I think I have decided what I want to do. So I'm going to take Mimosa Mammy in my crease. So I will put this in my whole crease. This was maybe a little bit more reddish than I expected it to be, but oh well, I can live with that. And with this palette, I wasn't like that intrigued to buy it, but then I started to see videos on it, and I think with the ColourPop's monochromatic palettes, I haven't been like, oh, I need that one with any one of the palettes. But then I see videos and I see them in real life, and then I'm like, that looks pretty good. It looks so good that I want to buy it. And it feels like it is like that with a lot of their monochromatic palettes for me. So I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing, but... And that was the Mimosa Mammy. And I don't know if I'm like super impressed. It is a good shade, but I think it's a little bit more red than I expected it to be, but I like it. Then I will go in with Rise and Grind, this one, and take it on the outside. So good to explain things. Take it out here. This was so much more orange. And I think I want to take this like up in my crease as well. Just a little bit. Okay, and don't go too overboard with the halo, as I like always do. It's looks more orange on the eye, this one, than it does in the pan. It is a little bit brighter on the eye than in the pan, and nothing against that at all. I'm actually happy about that. And okay, before I risk my life for this look, my eyesight for this look, I will go in with Sunkissed, this one, and put it in my halo, and I hope, I don't know how this will look, because Rise and Grind wasn't what I expected it to be. Okay, I like this as well. It feels a little bit powdery, if I'm going to be honest, but nothing wrong with it. This is also brighter than it looks in the pan, I think. This is what it looks like, and on the eye, I don't know how much you can see, but I really hope that you can see something. And I'm soon doing the thing that I am a little bit afraid of doing. Because I like how this is looking, but I think it's a little bit boring maybe. I will just go in with the shade I had in my crease, that Mimosa Miami. I want to say Mimosa Miami, but it's Miami. Just to put a little bit more in my crease. Okay, and then I actually want to go in with a Clementine on my halo, so on that sun-kissed, the lighter shade in the halo, I want to go in with this loose glitter, or this pressed glitter, and yes, it's not intended for the eyes, but... So, I will take some glitter glue, and I take this one from NYX, and then I'm going to be a little bit scared and afraid. And very quiet. Okay, I'm not afraid of this one. So, I'm putting it on the lighter shade in the middle. And just like tapping it on because I don't... Do you see what I'm doing? Just so I don't like drag out the shadow too much. Because I feel that this pressed glitter isn't... It has like no base, I think. So I want to put it on something. And then I'm going in with a brush that I hope can pick this up. Maybe I should just take my finger. Okay, it's sticking to the brush if I just... taking it around a little bit. And okay. If I'm going blind, I'm going blind. I'm just... press it on here. This feels a little bit stupid thing to do. Now I got it in my eyelash. Of course I got it in my eyelash. I don't really know what I think. It's some really big chunks of glitter in this glitter. Like, I have never been a glitter person. And I don't really know. I'm going to be it. Okay, I have some stuck in my eyelashes. But I think... this might be pretty... good. I don't know how I like it. I don't know if like doing, try to do a halo with a loose, with a pressed glitter was like the best idea ever. But I think it looks kind of cool. So cool that I want to be blind by it? No, but I think I like it. So I will do the other eyes. Hopefully don't get too much fallout of the glitter. Do my other eyes, fix my base and my brows, and then we come back. We do the under eyes, pray that I don't get glitter in my eye, and finished up this first impression. Okay, I don't really know what I want to do for my under eyes. And if you're wondering about my blush, I don't know how visible it is on camera. I have used this one. It's a stick blush from NYX. I really like them, but I don't know how to use them best. Here I just took with my finger, I don't know how much you can see. And here I did like this, but I think the finger is better because this blend isn't that good. Okay. What else? So, for my under eyes, I think I'll do the same because it feels like the shades I haven't used isn't that fun. If I'm not taking a glitter, maybe I should do a glitter on my whole lower lash. Then I think I maybe need a glitter glue. But we can try. I can try this Tangerine Dreams, this one. Sometimes it works with ColourPop shadows. Because they are... Some glitters are amazing, or some shimmers are amazing. They are like UVs, and some of them are like... Okay, so I will try without like any sticky base, not spray it or anything, and I will try and see this goes. Maybe this wasn't the best brush. But it's getting something. I don't know how much you can see though, and I think I maybe should have taken another shade as well. But I think I also will take a little bit on another brush. I will take this Mimosa Mammy as well and put it out here just to have. Okay, this was so cool on top on the glare, so I will take this the whole way. Okay, I actually think this is the finished look, or finished look with shadows. So I will put on something in my waterline. I will off to what? Of course, take an orange or maybe yellow. I think I will take an orange. Put on mascara and then a lippy, and then I will come back and I will tell you my first impression of the Orange You Glad palette from ColourPop. So this is the finished look, and I went like all orange. So for my lower lash, I took Unts from ColourPop, and for my lips, I took Orange County from NYX. It's their liquid suede, and I don't know about the lips. I think they are maybe a little bit too bright for the eyes, but that's just how I going to roll. And my hair, I never know what to do with it, and I don't like it. I don't like to have it down because it feels like it's like hair everywhere. And yeah, so I'm going to have my little band like this. I look like, have you seen Moomin? Is it Moomin in English? Moomin? Moomin in Swedish. And it's, I wonder what she can be named in English. She's Little Me in Swedish, or Lilla Me, and she has like red hair and a little bun like this, so yeah, I look like her. So okay, this is the finished look, and I like it. I like this pressed glitter, even though I didn't think I would do it, but I think it looks good. I'm just a little bit afraid to get it in my eyes and get blind, but what the fudge. I like this look. I think the thing I am most happy with is that this shade and this shade was so much brighter, or they were brighter on my eyes than in the palette. This one I felt like it's going to be like a neutral orange, but I think this was a good orange. So that makes me feel better about this palette, because first when I saw it, I was like, it's no fun orange colors, but I'm so glad that these two are more brighter on your eyes than in the palette. Really, really like that. Made me so happy. So yeah, my first impression with this is good. I am happy with the look. And yeah. The only thing, I think this would have been a better palette if these two shadows are like, you're doing a monochromatic palette, you don't have to have like a beige. Why? I don't know. But other than that, yes, I like this look. My first impression is good. I think this is a good palette. I like the Blue Moon as well, and I like the Ooh La La and Just My Luck. So yeah, I am happy with this look, and my next first impression, I think, is going to be with Honey. I never know how. I won't say Honey like the song, but that sounds like I'm stupid. And I can't say like Honey. Honey palette. I think that's going to be my next first impression. And then we are through with the first impression on these monochromatic palettes. And then I'm going to do a palette bingo with all of them. So yeah, that was all for this video. Do you have this palette, or do you want this palette? Are you thinking about getting this? Are you thinking about not getting this? Please let me know, and yeah, I'm going to end this now. So, I really hope you liked this video, and if you're not subscribing to my channel, please do so you don't miss any of my videos, and I hope I will see you in the next one. Bye!